Wait!
Yo, we gotta go before they come back.
No, nah. Drive for the whole weekend. Don't worry. Man, Lord of the Rings? I've read this like 5 times. It's like my favorite book.
Man, you don't even read.
What are you talking about? I don't only rob, it's a part-time job, I just read to keep my mind healthy.
Yo, check this out.
What?
Check it out.
Oh my gosh! Do you remember when we worked there? That's crazy.
Thank God it closed. It did close, right?
I don't know.
Yo, look.
Oh my gosh.
Man, he must be like 40 now.
Yeah, I remember him. That's insane.
I guess we can breathe a little bit.
Sure.
I have told this story many times. People refuse to believe it, which honestly seems natural to me given its nature. It's a story about joy and fear, suspense and adventure, all people and young people. And it begins with the name of a company, Orange Bandana Express Mail. I started working there many years ago, and like everyone, since I was no longer a teenager, I was expelled. But we'll get to that later. This book is also a detailed investigation about this company, and as the reader understands, what is odd is shocking. And not only that, odd things provoke a perfect narrative for an equally odd story. My story.
Luca!
Gabriel, I could not let him in.
You said it was urgent. You said it was urgent.
It is. What are we gonna do with this?
I'll deliver it myself.
The company has 3 rules. 1, they obviously use orange bandanas as a trademark. It's mandatory. Everyone has to wear them, regardless of their position. 2, mail must always be delivered, no matter what, no matter where. And 3, as you might already have noticed, they only hire teens, keeping to the precise meaning of the word, from 13 to 19. Then you have to leave.
What if you can't make it?
Couldn't we just let it go and not deliver?
Luca, what if you can't make it?
I have to.
I don't think it's a good idea. I don't think it's prudent.
Do you want to go instead?
I don't like this idea. But if Luca doesn't return, I'll get his position instead.
Go back to work.
This story is stupid. It doesn't really make any sense.
Shut up. And there I was, my face against the wind, ready for an adventure, heading to a place from which no other postman had ever returned before. Not because they died or anything extraordinary, no, but they never returned to work and nobody knew why. Some people said a creepy, angry man lived in that house that traumatized them for life. Other people say that girls lived there who would seduce them and they ended up crazy. For my sake, it was the first case.
What? I'm sorry. Keep going.
Hi. We were waiting for you.
I just need you to sign here, and I can get on my way.
Wait, what are you doing?
I just started with a book. I haven't finished writing it. But don't worry, because for you to understand what's next, you need to know a story that has already been told.
So what are you gonna do?
I don't know. I didn't know life contours so difficult.
Do you want some advice on someone who has gotten their bike stolen? Not once, but twice? Forget it.
What?
Oh, I have good news to you.
Here.
Wait, it's not for you. 6 years working here and you still don't know what mail looks like?
You want me to deliver this? It's almost 5 o'clock.
Would you rather spend the rest of your last day here? Come on, go for it.
Longwood? Wait, that's the house.
And tomorrow didn't come anyway. You'll have to come back.
Yeah, but
I know what you're thinking. I don't estimate enough. I just want you out of here.
Well, that's
none of that. You're a best postman. You think I would choose anyone else for this important task? Of course not. Second rule, mail must always be delivered.
Yes, but...
Well, of course. If you're a best postman, why send you in the first place? Such a dangerous place.
I don't...
Yeah, sure. I know you're willing to sacrifice yourself for others. But the place is just pure mints. There's nothing else to it. So what you say?
I don't...
Excellent! I know you can do it. Well, have fun this last time delivering mail.
That's not what I said. I said that I never stood at home.
So don't even worry about it.
I was such an incredible leader, you know. Notice the empathy and that conversation. In the end, always, everyone ended up happy.
We're waiting for you.
I just need you to sign this and I'm done with my work here.
Don't you want to know what happened to the other boy who came here?
Rafa.
Maybe you can save him. Are you wondering why he's not going to work? He's playing a game, you know. It's a very simple riddle. You can play too. If you answer correctly, no boy will be lost again.
What's the riddle?
Ah, the riddle. I'm not the one who gives it, young man. I'm just the butler in this house. But you can come in and find out for yourself. Wait here.
Thank you.
him.
Well, Reno, 3 points. Congratulations, you are in the second one.
Who are you?
Unimportant.
I'm out of here.
Don't you want to see Raphael and all your co-workers and finish with this misanthropy once and for all? Come on, Luca. 2 more riddles and that's it. I won't harm you. You know that I haven't harmed anyone that came before you.
Speak.
This one is very easy. You just have to select one object from the table. It will help you out on the third part. Select carefully.
To destroy the company. Why?
My dad, long dead, made this company and hired kids to save money. That shouldn't be allowed, and you know it.
We're here because we want.
Don't you realize the company's stupid? Second rule, mail must always be delivered. Imagine I saw everybody that came, and yet you still send people. You work here because it pays.
So?
That's it, I'm done.
Don't you want to know why no one returns to work? Open the box.
I told them the truth, that the company used them to save money and they're wasting their best years. Delivering what, mailboxes? Look, I have this whole house going for me. Does it help me? No? No, it doesn't.
He was right.
I knew he was right. But Orange Bandana Express Mail was all I had, and I wasn't willing to destroy it.
You're fired.
Whoa, calm down.
Where's Luca?
Get off, please. You can't be here.
Where is Luke? I have to speak with him now.
He went to deliver a package at the house. Wait! How'd he enter?
Gabriel went after Luca. He said it was his job. It's really hard to find good employees these days.
Thank you.
Well, I thought he would get very angry. But what he did was much, much worse.
What did he do?
Whoa, whoa, calm down. You're ruining the suspense. So...
the deal's a deal. You can walk out, just remember this.
What did he just do?
Did he die?
No, he just knocked him off, although we were extremely scared. We called an ambulance and everything. However, the next day, I really couldn't go to work. I was willing to close the company if it wasn't for...
Henry!
You didn't come today. Everyone tells me you've been brainwashed. Funny, right?
Did you know Rafael is in the municipal detention for 3 days? Attempted involuntary manslaughter.
He told me everything. He just got a little out of hand. Speaking of him, he wants you to have this.
At Henry's insistence, I went to work the next day. I still intended to close the company, but to my surprise, no one wanted to leave. I discovered that people worked there because they wanted to, because they loved being there. In the end, I too loved working there. It was awesome. What? What is your name?
Raul.
Raul, is this your first delivery, right?
Yeah.
Why do you want to work here?
I mean, who wouldn't want to?
Good.
Do you still have your black bandana?
Unimportant. But if you solve this riddle, you're hired. Which one
of the boxes of the story I just told you has never been seen before?